So today we are going to start from chapter number 2, that is health and hygiene. Open chapter number 2 of science book, Hariyap, health and hygiene. Okay, we have to start from the introduction. Yes, so what is meant by health and hygiene? It means that a clean environment. Hygiene means clean. It means a clean environment is very necessary for our health. But like, we need a clean environment to be healthy. So what should we do? Like, we need to keep our surroundings clean. We need to keep our classrooms clean. We need to keep our homes clean. We need to keep our playgrounds clean. So these are the things we need to keep clean for remaining healthy. We need to keep our environment clean if we want to remain healthy. So now you can look at the two pictures in your books and you can tell in which place would you like to live and why. The reason is obvious. So I will ask you at the end that in which place would you like to live. So we will start from the first line. A good living is possible when we live a healthy life. What is meant by a healthy life? Healthy life means when we remain fit, when we remain healthy. And how can we remain healthy? If our environment is healthy. If our environment is healthy, if our surroundings is healthy, means they are clean of dust, they are clean of any kind of pollution, of garbage, then we can remain healthy. But if we are living in such a kind of environment in which there is everywhere there is garbage and everywhere there are dust and pollution, so we cannot remain healthy in such a kind of environment, because many diseases will grow up in such a kind of a environment where there is so much garbage, there will be many diseases. So we need to start from our food. What do we mean by our food? Our food means the food that we eat makes up our diet. Like we like to eat healthy food. We like to eat junk food a lot. We like to eat pizza, burger. We like to eat. On the other hand, we don't like to eat much vegetables, much things like that. But we need to eat all such things if we want to remain healthy. We need to eat fruits, we need to eat vegetables, as well as chicken, meat, and milk. And we need to drink milk as well if we want to remain healthy. Because if we just keep on eating one thing again and again, then what will happen? That our body will be have an excess of that thing and will be deficient in some other things. And our body will be lacking some other things. Like if we go on eating chicken on daily basis, then our body will have much proteins, but it will not have much carbohydrates, it will not have much vitamins, it will not have much minerals, which are present in mostly fruits and vegetables. Vitamins and minerals are present in fruits and vegetables. So if we want to have fruits, if we want to have our body sufficient of fruit, vitamins and minerals, then we also need to eat fruits and vegetables, as well as we need to eat chicken, meat and such things, because all these things contain a little amount of nutrients. What are the nutrients? There are 5 nutrients. Okay, so what are these 5 nutrients? Carbohydrates, proteins, fats, vitamins and minerals, and roughage means fiber. So these are the nutrients. These are the 5 nutrients which our body needs. All these nutrients, not just 1 or 2 nutrients, our body needs all these nutrients in a right amount. So if we want to remain healthy, we need to eat food that will be rich in all these nutrients. So not only one kind of food will be rich in all these nutrients. Okay. So we need to eat all the foods that are rich in these nutrients, okay? So we need to eat chicken, we need to eat need, as well as we need to eat fruits and vegetables, we need to drink milk a lot, and also we need to eat such things which have a little bit fat, but not too much fatty food. Okay, we should not eat too much fatty food. We should eat a little bit food that is having fats in. Okay, so what are we studying? We are studying that things that we eat, that they make up our diet. What is a diet? A diet means a food which includes all, which includes nutrients in, like which include, like if we eat chicken, it includes proteins. If we eat bread, it includes fibers as well as carbohydrates. If we eat biscuits, they are rich in carbohydrates. Okay, if we eat fruits, they are rich in minerals and vitamins. If we eat vegetables, they are rich in minerals and vitamins. And if we drink milk, it is having minerals like calcium. So we need to eat all such things, a food variety which is rich in all these nutrients, not only just one kind of food. If we keep on eating one kind of food, our body will be deficient in the other nutrients. Okay, so we need to eat such a food which is having all these nutrients in our diet. So next is how much. Okay, you can underline in your first paragraph our food. The topic is our food. You need to underline the food we eat throughout the day makes up our diet. Our food contains nutrients like carbohydrates, proteins, fats, vitamins, and minerals. Okay, and we also need water and roughage in our diet. So you can underline the lines having the bold words. Okay, how much do you need to eat? It's a very simple question. The amount of food we eat, it depends upon our diet. Like how much healthy we are, how much taller we are. If we are children, we need more food as compared to adult, as compared to our adults, because obviously a child needs more food because he is in a growing age, he or she is in a growing age, and they need to eat more food. Okay, so if we are children, we need more food. If we are taller, we need more food. If like we have like people who make bill, they also need more food in the gyms. Like if they work out in the gyms, they need more food. So the type of food a person eats need depends upon his build, his or her build, or his or her like stamina. In an old age, a person would not eat much because his body does not need much food. In old age, a person does not eat much because his body does not need much food. But in a young age, a person eats more food because his body needs more food, okay? And a child needs more food because a child is in a growing age and he needs more food because to make up his build. So these are the types of it depends upon the type of person that how much food should they eat. And it depends upon a number of factors. Like which factors? Like his age, his height, his weight, and occupation. Like if he is healthy, so he needs more food. And if he is like smart and slim, not much healthy, so he does not need more food because his body is like it's not in a need of much food. So it depends upon age, height, weight, and occupation. Occupation means the type of work you do. Like some of the people are teachers, some of them are pilots, some of them are doctors, some of them are engineers. So it also depends upon these factors. Like masons who do much hard work, they need more food as compared to other people who do less hard work. Okay, so first point is children who are more active need more food. There are some children who are very much active, who are very much like they're running continuously, jumping and doing such things, so they need more food. Okay, people who do heavy work need more food than who do mild work. Like there are people who do much heavy work. Like there are masons at the construction sites who build houses, who build buildings. So they need more food, obviously, because they are doing much hard work as compared to people who do mild work, any less work, means not very much tough work. Tall and heavy people need more food than people who have a smaller build. Similarly, tall people or people who have a build, they need more food as compared to smaller people who have a smaller build. As people grow older and become less active, their food requirement becomes less. As soon as a person goes towards his old age, his need of food becomes less. Okay, now come to the next page. You can look at the diagram. It's having a food pyramid. You can look at this diagram. What are they telling you in this diagram? That there are some food proportions which are rich in nutrients, and there are which we should eat, and there are some foods which we should eat less. Okay, now you are seeing the boxes being made. What are they saying, telling you? Eat less, eat an appropriate amount, eat a lot, eat most. So eat most may, what do we see in eat most? Bread and cereal group. These the group which is rich in carbohydrates. We should eat a lot, eat most. And mostly we should eat such things which are rich in carbohydrates. Then eat a lot may, we see fruit group and vegetable group. Then eat an appropriate amount. What should we eat? In an appropriate amount, in a normal amount, meat or pulses or milk group. Then what should we eat? Less fats, oils and sweets. So we know that what kind of food we should eat less? Junk food, the fatty food. We should eat less the fatty food. So we know that all the type of food that we eat, it does not contain all the nutrients in the right proportion. Okay, so some foods are rich in carbohydrates, some are rich in proteins, some are rich in fats, some are rich in oils, and some are rich in vitamins and minerals. So it means that we cannot eat all the kind of food in the any food which is rich in all nutrients. Like every food has its own type. Some is rich in carbohydrates, some is rich in proteins, some is rich in fats. So it depends on us that which kind of food do we eat. If we eat junk food like burger, shawarma, pizza, they are rich in very much carbohydrates. They are very much rich in carbohydrates. But it is not very healthy for our body. Junk food is not healthy for our body. Why? Because junk food, like if we eat junk food, then our body makes most of the fat. So it is not very good. Okay, you can underline the definition of balanced diets. It's on page number 13. It's almost 10th line. First paragraph, 10th line, a diet that includes all the nutrients in the right proportion is called a balanced diet. Okay, so what is a balanced diet? A diet that includes all the nutrients like carbohydrates, proteins, fats, vitamins, minerals in their right proportion is called a balanced diet. What do we mean by it? It means that we should eat a kind of food which is rich in all the nutrients. Like we should, in a day, we should eat such things which are rich in all the nutrients. For example, starting from a day, when we start eating like breakfast, then we will have some lunch, and after it we will have some snacks and then dinner. So what our food should be like in our day? Like we should eat roti, we should eat, we should drink milk, we should eat fruits, and in lunch we can eat vegetables, and at dinner we can eat some kind of meat or chicken. Then if we just eat like make a chart and eat these things, then what will happen, that our body will be having sufficient of the nutrients, because we are eating all the kind of food items, not only one kind of food item, we are eating all the kinds of food item in the right amount. So you can underline the definition that if we just eat all the nutrients in a right amount, in a right proportion, then it is called a balanced diet. A diet that includes all the nutrients in the right amount is called a balanced diet. Okay, so before starting the next paragraph, I would like to show you some images related to this topic, so you can just understand by looking at them. Okay, so okay, so now you are on your screen, there is a picture given of a balanced diet. Okay, so what you can understand from a balanced diet, all the nutrients which are needed by our body in the right amount is called a balanced diet. So you know what is a balanced diet? All the nutrients which are needed by our body in a right amount is called a balanced diet. Means that, like, we should eat a diet which is rich in all the nutrients. That will be called a balanced diet. Okay, now coming to the next, five major nutrients. So you know that there are five major nutrients: carbohydrates, fats, proteins, vitamins, minerals, and fibers. So these are the five major nutrients. Vitamins and minerals we include in one category. Okay. Next, food pyramid. Okay, a food pyramid is shown in your book. So a food pyramid is also shown over here. What do you see from this food pyramid? A healthy food pyramid means if we just eat these things in the right amount, we will be healthy. Our body will be healthy. So what is a healthy food pyramid? It shows that we should eat 5% fat, oil, sugar, and sweets. Means such things which are fatty, oily, or having more sugar or sweets, we should eat less. Like how much? 5%. Then how much food we should eat? 20%. Meat, fish, milk, and eggs. This kind of food, we should eat 20% of this food. Okay, like meat, fish, milk, and eggs. Okay, and then 35% fruit and vegetables. So there is a proportion given, like 5% you should eat fatty food, 20% meats, 35% fruits and vegetables. Means 35% you can intake vitamins and minerals, and then 40% bread, potato, and cereals. So there is a percentage given in which you can, which can tell you how much nutrients you should take. Like 5% we can have fats and oils and sugar and sweets. 20% we can have meat, fish, milk, and eggs. 35% fruits and vegetables, and 40% bread, potato, and cereals. Now this will be called a healthy food pyramid. Okay, now coming to the next. Okay, this is a healthy plate. A healthy plate means that how much, what kind of food should we eat which will keep ourselves healthy. Like 1/2 portion vegetables, 1/4 portion grain food, 1/4 portion proteins. So this will be a healthy plate. What is a healthy plate? Like 1/4 grain. In grain food comes, like, we can eat porridge, potato, cereals, which are having carbohydrates. Grain food means food which is having carbohydrates. How much percent should we eat? 1/4. Now, 1/4 protein. Now, you can see in the protein portion, there is chicken, egg, milk, fish, and these things are given. So, we can eat how much? 1/4 protein. Portion of we should eat food that is having proteins. Now 1/2 percent vegetables, like vegetables are shown, vegetables and fruits both are shown in this picture, and in the last, how much we should drink water. So this is a healthy food in which we are having carbohydrates, which we are having proteins, we are having fruits and vegetables, and we are having water. So this will be our healthy food. If we just eat these things, we will be healthy. Okay, now coming to the next slide. Nutrients in fruits. Now what are they telling you? That nutrients in fruits, how nutrients in fruits are keep us healthy, like they have shown you watermelon and strawberries. So what are the functions of these two fruits? Watermelon, it hydrates the body, means it keeps water in our body. It keeps kidneys healthy. It reduces inflammation, means it reduces burning and like buns. If we are having buns, it can reduce it. Good for your bones, improves immunity. Okay, then strawberries boost short-term memory, like it can boost, means it can enhance your memory. Low in calories, high in fiber. It is having more fiber, it is having less calories, means an old age person can also eat a lot of strawberries because it is having less calories. Okay, anti-aging properties means it is anti-aging. Then prevent esophageal cancer. Okay, then lower cardiovascular disease, means it also reduces diseases. So these are the benefits of having fruits in your diets. They will keep you healthy and they will make like less disease, they will cause less diseases. Then next slide, nutrients in tomatoes. What are they telling you? Now nutrients in vegetables. So what does a tomato do for us? It keeps our skin healthy, it supports bone health, it improves vision, means it improves our eyesight, it reduces hair problems, it lowers blood sugar levels. Okay, it helps prevent several types of cancer. Cardiovascular support means heart support. Provides antioxidants, anti-cancer, helps out smoking, helps quit smoking. Okay, means if a person is smoking and he can just, if he wants to avoid smoking, he can just eat tomatoes. Okay, it will reduce his his smoking. Okay, now some foods have nutrients to prevent hair loss. Now if you are having too much hair loss, then there are some foods which are having nutrients that will prevent hair loss, like proteins in the first slide. Proteins, like which food will give us proteins? Eggs, milk, meat, then fishes, omega-3, this is like a kind of vitamins. Fishes and what else is shown here? I think meat is shown. Then iron. Okay, which food gives us iron? Chicken. And again, there are some vegetables shown, beans and spinach. Okay, then vitamin C. Okay, vitamin C, how from we gain from like by eating fruits. So which fruits? Juicy fruits like citrus fruits and also juices. And strawberries. Now vitamin A is like carrots, and also there is like a picture given of some vegetable, I think it's pumpkin. And then vitamin B12, there are eggs and meat. Okay, so these are all the slides which I have shown you to make you help in understanding what is meant by a balanced diet. Like if we keep on eating these things, we will remain healthy. So what you have gained from this healthy plate, a food pyramid, nutrients in fruits and nutrients in vegetables. So these are all the slides which keep us healthy. Okay, which keep us healthy. learn from these things that if we, you can okay mark over here, we will read till balanced diet. Okay, the food, next different food groups we will read from tomorrow. Different food groups we will read in the next lecture. So what we have studied today about food and about balanced diet, that we should eat a kind of diet which is rich in all the nutrients, which is having all the nutrients in a right amount, and not just keep on eating one kind of food. Because if we just keep on eating one kind of food, our body will be having an excess of that food and will be deficient in the other food. So we should eat a kind of variety which is rich in all the nutrients. So what we should eat most, we should eat most the bread and cereal groups, which is having most carbohydrates, and then we should eat fruits and vegetables, and then we should eat food that is having proteins, and what we should eat less, fats and oils. Okay, we should eat less the junk food. Okay, so now I'm going to ask from you that what do you understand from the topic. Yes, you can unmute yourself, all of you.
Jim, what is your word?
Yes.
Homework.
Homework?
Yes.
Okay, homework will be your question answers of this chapter. You can do. Okay, open page number 22. Part C. No, sorry, part D. Part D. Answer these questions in short. Your homework will be first two short question answers. What is a balanced diet? How does milk food group help? Okay.